In this video, I'm going to show you how to do probability calculations with continuous and discrete probability distributions in Rguroo. From the probability simulation pane, select probability, scroll down to probability calculator, and here you will see the options to choose between performing a continuous probability calculation or a discrete probability calculation. Let's first start by exploring the continuous probability calculator. At the top right of this dialog box, you'll see two radio buttons. The radio button values to probability calculates the probabilities for various ranges of a random variable, as we will explain in this video. The probability to values radio button performs a so-called inverse probability calculation, where you would give a probability value and an interval of those values corresponding to that probability is calculated. To learn more about calculating inverse probabilities, please refer to our video, Inverse Probability Calculator. Now, by clicking on the distribution dropdown, you'll be able to select a random variable. Below the distribution dropdown is where you define the parameters for the distribution that you selected. Under the parameter specification boxes is where you would enter the range of the values for which you would like to compute your probability. The four types of calculations available are below, above, between, and outside. There is a fifth option, equal, that is available for discrete distributions. You can also perform multiple calculations at once by hitting the green plus button at the bottom left-hand corner of the dialog box. Let's begin by clicking on calculation 1 and use the default assumptions of a normal distribution with mean 0 and standard deviation of 1. For this calculation, let's find the probability that our random variable is below 2. Now click on calculation 2. For our second calculation, let's find the probability that our random variable will be between 1 and 4, but under the assumption of an F distribution, with numerator degrees of freedom of 5 and denominator degrees of freedom as 7. The non-centrality parameter will be set as 0. Each calculation can be given its own unique name should you want to filter more easily between all calculations. So let's rename this calculation F distribution. Click the preview icon, and we will now see the value of 0.43211 displayed in the gray box for the F distribution. And if we click back on calculation 1, we will now see the probability of 0.97725. You can also see visuals for these calculations by selecting the graph checkbox either next to the calculation name or in the graph checkbox in the lower bottom section. I'm going to hit these checkboxes for both calculations. Let's now hit the preview icon and see the results. In this report layout, you will see a statement indicating the distribution of our random variable, the expected value and variance, and the probability statement in both plain English and mathematical notation, along with the distribution plot. By scrolling down to the F distribution output, you will see the same output structure as calculation 1, but with an F distribution. Let's open a new calculator so that I may show you how the axis limit and tolerance features work. Go back over to the probability simulation pane, select probability, scroll down to probability calculator, and then click on continuous. Now when we hit the graph checkbox, the axis limit and the tolerance options become interactive. The axis limit boxes let you enter the left and right axis limits so that you may zoom in or zoom out on your plot. When no axis limit is specified, the tolerance boxes can be set to determine how far the x-axis should be stretched on the right and the left. For example, if we set the right value to 0.0003, then the right tail of the distribution will be extended to the point where a 0.003 probability remains in the right tail. It's important to note, however, that the axis limits will override the tolerance should you enter values in both. Suppose this time we have a chi-squared distribution with 5 degrees of freedom, and a non-centrality parameter of 0. And we want to calculate the probability that our value will be above 15. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to hit the green plus button and duplicate the distribution and parameters from calculation 1. However, for calculation 2, I'm going to hit the graph checkbox and change its x limits to go from 12 to 25. This will give us an alternate way of visualizing this calculation. Let's hit the preview icon to see our results. Calculation 1 shows the probability plot with the default tolerance values in Rguroo, while calculation 2 shows the same probability plot, but with an emphasis on the x limits that we set from 12 to 25. I'm going to show you one more example, but this time using a discrete distribution. Scroll back over to the probability simulation toolbox, select probability, hit probability calculator, and then click on discrete. You'll notice that the discrete distribution calculator looks pretty much identical to the continuous distribution calculator, but it has an added checkbox next to the calculation value we want to perform. This checkbox allows you to calculate the probability that an observation is exactly equal to the value specified. Simply put, less than becomes less than or equal to when you select this box. We call this the equality checkbox. Suppose we have a binomial distribution with 20 trials and a probability of success as 25%. Let's calculate the probability of less than 7 successes occurring. Since we do not want to include 7, we uncheck the equality checkbox. I also want to see the graph. We are now ready to hit the preview icon and see the results. From here, we see the probability that our random variable is less than 7 successes is 78.58%. To learn more about various distribution parameters, please refer to the appendix titled Probability Distributions from our user guidebook. And if you would like further details and examples on how to use the continuous and discrete probability calculators, we also encourage you to reference the chapter Probability Calculator.